Well, good morning students. So in the last class we have seen about the event handling. So today also we will see one more example of this event handling. Lastly, we have seen a program to display hello good morning while clicking on a button. So today we will see what to do, what can be done using text boxes. And we will use the same event for event handling, that is click event. So click events are handled by action listener. Okay, so first of all, I am importing the packing box. Import java.awt.start. Okay, then for handling events I am importing import java.awt.event.star. Okay, as you know, inside AWT there is a subfolder called event, and inside that we have different classes for handling this events. Okay, that is java.awt.event.star. Okay, now I am using a class. I can give as graph 5 something, class graph 5. Inside that I am using the frame class, frame object, then panel object, panel p1. Okay, then text field t1 comma t2. I am using two text boxes. Then I am using a button b1. Okay, so we have this much controls. Frame is the basic container, panel is the container. So without using frame, without using panel, if we add the components to the frame, then the component will be visible, will be covered in the full area of the frame. The frame is a component idea, and a component the mottam edeyum frame nadu. വീണ്ടും വേറൊരു ഒരു കമ്പൗണ്ട് ആഡ് ചെയ്യുകയാണെങ്കിൽ അത് എൻ്റെ മുകളിലാണ് വരിക. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് വി ആർ യൂസിങ് പാനൽസ്. അപ്പോൾ പാനൽ ഉപയോഗിക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് വി ക്യാൻ ഹാവ് ദീസ് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ലേഔട്ട്സ് ഓൾസോ. ലേഔട്ട് മീൻസ് അറേഞ്ച്മെൻറ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് കമ്പോണൻസ് ആണ്, അത് പിന്നെ പഠിക്കും. സോ ലേഔട്ട്സ് ആർ അറേഞ്ച്മെൻറ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് കമ്പോണൻസ്. അപ്പോൾ വി ആർ യൂസിങ് പാനൽസ് ഫോർ അറേഞ്ച്മെൻറ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് കമ്പോണൻസ്. ഓക്കെ, ആൻഡ് ദി ഡിഫോൾട്ട് ലേഔട്ട് ഈസ് ഫ്ലോ ലേഔട്ട് ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് യൂസ്ഡ് ഹിയർ. The default layout is flow layout. That's what we use here. In the end, we constructor create a graph 5 is the class name. So f1 is equal to new frame. I am giving the heading as graphics. Okay. F1 equal to new frame. P1 is equal to new panel. Okay, mind that the first letter is capital always, panel. Then b1 is equal to new button. You can give the text of the button there, caption of the button there as click me. Then t1 is equal to new text field. We need to give the size of the text field in brackets. So t1 equal to new text field. Similarly, t2 is equal to new text field. So we have two text fields. Now add the components. So p1 dot add t1, one text box is added. p1 dot add t2, second text box is added. Then p1 dot add b1, the button is added, and the panel is added to frame. F1 dot add. Okay, now we have to set the size of the set size 300,300, the width and height of the pixels. Okay, then f1 dot set visible true. So these are the code for displaying this graphical interface, user interface, UI. Graphical interface is shown by using this. And Okay. Now I am using this second class inside. I am using the first class main function public static void main string arg. Okay. Inside that I am creating the object of this graph class equal to new graph file. Okay. Now I need to there is no need to call. Okay, because it is given the constructor. Okay, so we will check the program, this program first for arrays. Okay, file save. I need to save the file. The file is saved in home folder. Okay. Okay, so I have saved the file as graph file. Now I would like to compile this. Java C graph5.java. Okay, semicolon expected. So error is there. F1.addP1, where is that? Was error. F1 equal new frame graphics. Okay. Then dot is missing. Import java dot awt dot even dot star. Okay. Okay, so compile again. Java C graph5.java. What happened? Java C graph5.java cannot find symbol graph5.java. Okay, what is error? Class graph file. Class graph file. Okay, we'll name it as graph 6. We'll see what the error is. Okay, graph 6. Graph 6. Graph 6. File save as graph6.java. Okay. Compile. Java C graph6.java. Error. Graph 6 equal to new graph 6. Variable graph 6. Location graph 6. Class is opened. Graph class graph 6. Okay. Opening bracket. Graph 6 constructor is opened. Main function public static void main graph 6 equal to new graph 6. What happened? Class graph 6. Okay, Java classes, okay. Just write ls graph6.java is there. What is here? Graph6 equal to no graph6. Symbol variable graph6. മനസ്സിലാകുന്നില്ലല്ലോ. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദാറ്റ്? ഇമ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്തു, ക്ലാസ് ഡിഫൈൻ ചെയ്തു, ഓപ്പണിംഗ് ബ്രാക്കറ്റ് കൊടുത്തു, graph6 കൊടുത്തു, പബ്ലിക് സ്റ്റാറ്റിക് വോയിഡ് മെയിൻ, സ്ട്രിംഗ് graph6 ഈക്വൽ ടു ന്യൂ graph6. Okay, check the errors. Okay, got the error. We have not given the object name. Graph 6 G2 is equal to new graph 6. The object name was not given. That's why. So, graph 6 equal to okay. Graph 6 object name equal to new graph 6. Now we will compile java c graph6.java. okay, java graph6. okay, so we have the interface, two text boxes and a button. Nothing will happen on clicking because we have not given the code. Okay, now we will give the code for this. Okay, we will give the code for this also. So what we want to do is to give event handling. Okay, so I am defining a class to implements. Okay, we have to derive it from the action listener. So class 2 implements action listener. So this is the class which handle the action listener, interface which handles the actions. Inside that I am giving public void action performed action event e. So what happens is that when an action is occurred, the object is called by this function and the body is executed. Okay, so we'll give the body as what we need to give. Think that I need to swap the contents of the text boxes. So I am giving as a string, t5 is equal to text box name is t1, so t1.getText. So I have obtained the value of text entered in the text box t1 to a string variable t5, and string t6 is equal to t2.getText. So getText is used for getting the method, getText method is the method used for getting a string from the text box. So we have two variables t5 and t6. Now we need to set t1.setText. SetText is for setting the text. What has to be set? I need to set t6. Similarly, t2.setText, we can use t5. So this is the code. This is the code, actual code for interchanging. And it has been done inside this function public void action perform. Okay. So class 2 implements action listener. So listeners are interfaces which listens for events and whenever an event is occurred, it is caught by this function. In either every day and listen to another, So we need to close the class here also. So this class is a inner class of the outer class. That is inner class. About inner class, the advantage is that it can access the variables of outer class directly. T1, T2, text box in the background. These can be accessed by the T1, T2 outer class in the variables are here, text box or other inner class in the other. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഈവൻ്റ് ഹാൻഡ്ലിംഗ് ക്ലാസ്സിനകത്ത് കൊടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. അതിനകത്ത് കൊടുക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഈസി ടു ആക്സസ് ദി വേരിയബിൾസ്. ഓക്കെ, ഇതൊക്കെ ബൈൻഡ് ചെയ്യാൻ ബാക്കിയുണ്ട്. എങ്ങനെ ബൈൻഡ് ചെയ്യാതെ വി നീഡ് ടു ക്രിയേറ്റ് ദി ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ക്ലാസ്. സോ ടു ടി ടി ഇസ് ഇക്വൽ ടു ന്യൂ ടു ഐ ഹാവ് ക്രിയേറ്റ് ദി ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ഇന്നർ ക്ലാസ് ഇൻ ദി ഔട്ടർ ക്ലാസ്. നൗ ഐ നീഡ് ടു ബൈൻഡ്. സോ ലിസൺ ദി ഈവൻ്റ് ഓൺ ദി ബട്ടൺ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ബി വൺ ഡോട്ട് add action listener tt. So this is the method of binding. So first we create the object of the class, then we need to bind the listener object to the button v1. Okay, now we will see what happens. Java syntax. Okay, here is Java graph 6. Okay, we have interface now with size 300. Now I am giving some text here. Okay, now it is happy. Okay, so after entering the text, we can click on this button to have the swapping. So the body of this button is to swap. As you can see, the body of the button is to swap. Okay, public static void main string arg, this is the body of the first interface. This is the class which handle the action. So class 2 implements action listener. This class 2 is the listening class which got the property by implementing from action listener. Okay, then public void action perform, that is a function which executes during a click. Whatever click happens, that is a function executed, and so we are binding the click to the button here. And so whenever we click on the button b1, this function will get executed, and the body of the function is to swap the text. Get text is for getting the text from text box. Set text is the method for setting the text. Okay, so this is the second example for the event handling program. Okay, watch the video again. Thank you.